Hi guys, welcome back to another video of Edubit channel. So today's topic is toxemia or endotoxemia. We are all familiar with the toxins and many toxins produced by many pathogenic bacteria and some protozoans and all. So whenever these toxins are present in blood, the condition is called as toxemia. So if you haven't subscribed our channel yet, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button for more updates. So moving to the first and very important part, that is the definition part. Toxemia is a clinical systemic state caused by widespread activation of host defense mechanisms to the presence of toxin produced by the bacteria or any injury to tissue cells. So bacteria will be producing many toxins. So our body, our host defense mechanism will be activated against that toxin. So that condition is known as the toxemia. So toxemia does not include the disease caused by toxic substances produced by plants or insects or ingested organic or inorganic poisons. So moving to the etiology, toxins are of two types. The first one is the antigenic toxins, that is the structural part of the bacteria or any organism that is itself acting as the toxin. Or the next is metabolic toxins, that is any part which is produced during the metabolism of any part, that is actually known as the metabolic toxins. Antigenic toxins are preformed toxins, the antigens. Metabolic toxins are produced inside the body during metabolism. So the first one is antigenic toxins. These are produced by the bacteria and to a lesser extent by the helminths. Antigenic toxins stimulate the production of antibody in the host animal. They have got the name antigen because they are generating antibody. That's why they have got the name antigen. So antigenic toxins are divided into mainly exotoxins and endotoxins. Exotoxins are proteinaceous substances produced by the bacteria which diffuse into the surrounding medium, and they will be producing many lesions and symptoms. They are specific in their pharmacological effects and the antibodies they induce. So they will be inducing specific antibody and they will be having specific pharmacological effects inside the body. Example, the exotoxin produced by the Clostridium species and the enterotoxins released by the enterotoxigenic E. coli, both are exotoxins. Next is the endotoxin, which are lipopolysaccharide found in the outer cell wall of bacteria. So they will be releasing their lipopolysaccharides, which will be acting as endotoxins. They are released into the immediate surroundings when the bacteria undergo rapid proliferation, or whenever the bacterial cell wall breaks, that is mainly in the case of coliform mastitis. So moving to the metabolic toxins. Metabolic toxins are toxic chemical substances that accumulate in the body as a result of incomplete elimination of toxic material. Whenever the body is undergoing elimination of toxic material, they will be conducting many steps. So whenever a step is incomplete or the elimination is incomplete or which is conducting through the abnormal metabolism, metabolic toxins are born. So normally these toxins are excreted in the urine and feces or detoxified in the plasma and liver. Example, in hepatic dysfunction, toxins that are normally detoxified by the liver accumulate in the system. So ketonemia is due to abnormal fat metabolism. And lactic acidemia is due to abnormal rumen acidosis. So, ketone bodies are metabolic toxins in case of ketosis. And in case of lactic acidosis, lactic acid produced by the abnormal metabolism in the rumen due to acute ruminal acidosis is the metabolic toxin. So, moving to the pathogenesis of endotoxemia, how does they attack the body system? The toxic moiety of the lipopolysaccharide molecule of the bacteria is generally similar. So endotoxemia results in an extraordinary sequence of pathophysiologic effects involving all body systems. endotoxins induce the release of biochemical mediators such as platelet activating factors, prostaglandins. So that will actually result, or they will be inducing the histamine, serotonin, etc. So there will be a regional vasoconstriction, systemic hypertension. Sometimes extensive endotoxin release will lead to anaphylaxis and anaphylactic shock. That can even lead to organ dysfunction and death. So clinical findings of endotoxemia. So due to the widespread presence of toxins and their moiety and their characteristic approach towards the organs, they will be producing depression, muscle weakness, fever and congested mucous membrane. And in the early stages, heart rate and cardiac output increases. That is actually due to vasoconstrictive effect. This is known as the hyperdynamic phase of endotoxemia. Next is actually the hypodynamic phase. That is, the uncontrolled endotoxemia proliferates. It leads to cardiac output level will be decreased. And we will be going hypothermic, and animal becomes cool and become hypotensive and hypothermic. Other findings include diarrhea, that is actually due to the endotoxemia will be mainly acting on the gut region, and whenever they are acting in the kidney tubules, the decreased urinary output will be there, petechial or ectomegalic hemorrhages on the mucosal membrane and sclera will be there. In chronic toxemia, we will be going to the acute renal failure or chronic renal failure and all. Mainly we'll be exhibiting the chronic renal failure, anemia and emaciation. So moving to the laboratory findings and clinical pathology. First of all, we will be checking the blood cells, the condition of the blood cells or the count of blood cells. Whenever leukocytes and neutrophils are very high, we can directly move into the conclusion that endotoxemia is present. In severe cases, leukopenia develops due to neutropenia and lymphopenia. That is, leukocytes will be decreasing because the cells will be attacked by the toxins and all. So our body system will be attacking those neutrophils which have captured the toxins. So serum biochemistry, there is no diagnostically important alteration in serum biochemistry. Moving to the diagnosis, the diagnosis will be mainly from the history, clinical sign and laboratory findings and postmortem lesions. Treatment of endotoxemia. The principles of treatment of endotoxemia or any septic shock due to endotoxins include, the first one will be remove the foci of infection. First of all, we need to remove the agent of infection. Next is administration of broad spectrum antimicrobial agents with gram negative spectrum or a combination of antibiotics depending upon the severity. Mainly, we will be moving to the fluoroquinolones and aminoglycosides, etc. Next is aggressive fluid and electrolytic therapy to correct the hypovolemia or hypoglycemia and electrolytic and acid base balance. That is, isotonic fluids such as normal saline or dextrose normal saline are given to correct the hypovolemia, and balanced electrolytic solution, that is Ringer's lactate, to correct the acid base and electrolytic imbalances. To prevent hypoglycemia, we can add glucose solution or we can feed through orally or through parenteral route. Hypertonic saline, that is 7.5% sodium chloride, enhances the tissue perfusion and decreases the volume of fluid to be administered. Better option, that is hypertonic saline. Fluid therapy also aids in the dilution and excretion of toxin from the host. Whenever more fluid therapy is applied, urination will be increased and glomerular filtration of the toxins will be at higher rate and the toxin will be excreted from the body in a faster way. Next is NSAIDs or glucocorticoids to inhibit the production of cyclooxygenase pathway. That is, extra inflammatory reactions will be suppressed by the NSAIDs or glucocorticoids. So better use NSAIDs which is having less analgesic property and less blood clotting property. So the flunixin meglumin or the meglodine which is produced by the Virbac is very common, and that is used in NSAIDs in horse and ruminants. So NSAIDs should be rarely used or used with caution in case of dogs and cats. So the steroids which are mainly used is actually the dexamethasone. So next is the supportive therapy, that is actually the vasopressor agents, hydrotropic agents, anticoagulants and B-complex vitamins. So moving to the prognosis part. Prognosis is good in early stages of endotoxemia. Persistence of severe neutropenia and high lactate in blood and hypotension are poor prognostic. Thank you.